And now our final lesson in the basic roofs here. We've had a little bit of fun and learned some stuff. Shed roof, and this time we're going to use a slope arrow. So I'm going to go up here, same as I did before. I can delete this reference plane from my previous lesson. Inside of my level 2 here, where the roof is going to go, I'm going to start with the roof by footprint. And if it's the last one, I can also just pick right here on the top. I'm going to set my offset to be 2 feet. I'm going to hover over this edge, and it depends on where you are. Tab. Now you see I'm tabbing, and what's doing is it's tabbing this thing. I need to pick inside of here. Very important you make this the current window. Then when you hover and you tab, it'll pick all those edges and then click. Now again, it's adding slope into all those edges. Escape, escape, hover, tab, click, turn the slope off. Boom. Now we would have what would be a flat roof. If I just say finish the roof right now, okay, we can finish that flat roof. Now the nice thing about a flat roof is once you pick on a flat roof, you can actually go in here and use all kinds of modify and add points and add high and low points. We've got lots of CAD clips on to create roof drains and basically a sloping flat roof. But that's not our lesson here. We're going to add in a slope arrow. So watch, I'm going to pick on this roof. I'm going to go into here and say edit the footprint. Now inside of there, I'm going to use something called slope arrow, which is right here. Slope arrow. Bink. I'm going to draw the slope arrow, and I'm going to say sloping from here that way. Okay? And now escape, escape. What you do is you pick on the slope arrow itself. You've got your different ways of making that. You can say I want to define that slope by giving just a slope over 12, or I can define it by saying offset at the head and offset at the tail. Okay, so you can manage that through two offsets, level at tail, level at head. Takes a little bit of trial and error, or we can simply say slope, and I'm going to go in here and create my 312 slope, click out, and then finish my roof. So sloping up from here to here at 312. Finish the roof, click out, and you could also see that slope arrow was down here in our 3D view, by the way. I want to pick on here, and I can go back and say edit footprint. Okay, you'll see that slope arrow is right there. Okay, and if I want, I can change it, you know, maybe it's a 412. Okay, click out, and then finish the roof. Done, done. Hover over here, tab, select all my walls, and then I say attach the top. You have to make sure it says top, which is the default to this roof. Click out, and there you have your shed roof with a slope arrow. So hopefully inside of these 8 or 9 lessons, we've taught you a little bit about using the basic roof tools in Revit Architecture 2011, but this applies all the way back to 2010, 2009. Nothing I've shown you here is really any different in the last 3 versions of Revit. And of course, at www.cadclips.com, we have lots more videos with more detailed information on creating more Revit objects. Thanks, and hope you learned something. Bye for now.